show on Saturday, we had a phenomenal junior middleweight showdown between Jermell Charlo and Brian Castaño. A back and forth war for 12 rounds in that fight that was marred by another terrible scorecard. Nelson Vasquez scored the fight 117-111, which means he gave Castaño just 3 rounds. Sergio, this isn't the first time we've seen a horrible scorecard. It won't be the last time we see a horrible scorecard. What can boxing do about bad judging?
By holding bad scorecards and the judges who turn them in responsible. You gotta find them. You gotta find them and hit them where it hurts, and that's the wallet, Mannix, or else nothing's gonna change. You gotta suspend them. You gotta keep them from working. You gotta relegate them to undercard chores and ballroom. Don't give them these huge mega fights. I mean, this was for the undisputed championship of the world, and it got marred by a disgrace of a scorecard in 117-111. And what was a fantastic fight. I mean, it was a great fight. I thought Castaño won that fight convincingly, but it is subjective, and I'm not a professional judge. So how do you fix it? Hit them where it hurts. Find them, suspend them, get rid of them. Make an example out of one of these guys.
Well, I don't think you can find them for a bad scorecard. You can suspend them. You can relegate them to lower tier fights. There's no governing body when it comes to judges. Every state does things a little bit differently. The state of Nevada, the commission there will give you a pool of judges to effectively choose from. Texas, where we saw this fight take place, will take your advice on judges and then pick them accordingly. I'm not looking to shake up the system right now, Sergio, though I'd love to see some kind of national ranking system. What I'd like to start with is to have the best 3 judges in boxing always used on the best fights. And if you ask promoters or managers or trainers, they know who these judges are. Steve Weisfeld, who we saw on the Charlo Castaño card, an elite judge, probably the best judge in all of boxing. You can go to Dave Moretti in Nevada, Glenn Feldman in Connecticut, Julie Letterman out in New York. These are the names that keep coming up whenever I ask promoters to name the 3 best judges. Why not make sure, whatever you have, a televised or a pay-per-view event, that 3 of those judges are always used? I mean, Nelson Vasquez, he's like 75, 80 years old. Like, what are we doing with this? Like, at some point, you've got to find the 3 best guys, or male or women, in boxing and make them the judges on your most highest profile cards. From there, we'll figure the rest of it out because it's still a problem. But for the big time fights, let's have the best possible judges.
Yeah, and you're right. I think Steve Weisfeld is at the top of that list. And we only need 3 judges. Out of all those names, pick 3 and use them for the entire country. I agree with that. And you touched on something. This fight was held in Texas, where they like pressure. They like volume punching. They like the fighter going forward. That was Castaño for about 8-9 rounds. But you got to give Jermell credit. He's a champion. Both of them are champion. But Jermell Charlo closed the show like a champion. And a lot of times, fans, and the average fan especially, they remember what happened in the end. They don't remember what happened in the beginning. But it's a judge's job to turn in scorecards every round. It doesn't matter who closed out the fight late. It doesn't matter who got hurt. If they didn't drop them, most likely that's not a 10-8 round. A lot of things went wrong here, but the one thing that went wrong here is that one scorecard just marred the entire event, and that's where we have a bad taste in our mouth.
Jermell Charlo was losing. And the only person we need to listen to on this was Derek James, Jermell Charlo's trainer, who from the 9th round on was saying, "You're losing. You've got to knock this guy out." Derek James knew he was losing. People watching on TV knew he was losing. The only person involved in that fight that didn't think Jermell Charlo was losing was Nelson Vasquez.
Thanks for watching this video. Please do subscribe All Media New York.